Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hope you all are doing good with your health. Children, today we are going to learn about what is a universe. What all things consist of universe. Okay? During the day, what all things you find in the sky, the same things are not found in the night as well. During the day, when you look at the sky, you can find sun. If it is a sunny day, you can find the sun, the glowing bright sun. Okay, then during the night, whereas during the night hours, we find stars, isn't it? The moon as well. If at all it is seen. So the stars what you find in the sky during the night are much bigger, the larger than the earth. They are bigger or larger than the earth. They are million times bigger than the earth. Why do we see them as a very tiny object? Because they are very, very, very far away from us. And the stars are not the same what we look with our naked eye. Okay? They are just a burning and glowing balls. Glowing balls of hot gases. So that is the reason we find them twinkling, shining. Okay? So the stars are the burning and glowing balls of hot gases. They are not as we see what we see with our naked eye. Naked eye in the sense, directly what you look, when you look into the sky, when you gaze at the sky, you find many number of stars, millions and trillions of stars, you find them. So why do they look like twinkling? Because they are the hot burn. They are made up of hot gases. Okay, then coming to the solar system. What do you mean by solar system? Solar system consists of sun, 8 planets, some other objects like comets, asteroids, etc. Those gases, whatever they are found in the space. So what do you mean by a solar system? Solar system consists of 8 planets, sun, comets, these are the small objects, and some asteroids. When you look into the picture, or when you look into the, when you imagine in the universe, how is the solar system formed? How is it formed with the sun? This is the sun, you imagine. 8 orbits. Nearly 8 orbits are found in an oval shape. See, I didn't prove it in a circular shape. It is in the form of somewhat oval shape. Oval in the sense, when you look at an egg, how is the shape of an egg? So this is the orbits around the sun are formed. In that orbit you find 8 planets. Okay. You find 8 planets. Previously you were having 9 orbits. The 9th orbit is deleted. It is not being taken into consideration because the planet Pluto is considered as a dwarf planet. So it is being eliminated. So we have only now at present we have 8 planets, the sun, comets, asteroids and other smaller objects whatever present in the solar system, in the universe constitutes the solar system. So we have gone through the 8 planets. What are the 8 planets? The 8 planets are Mercury. It stands first, the first orbit. Okay, the orbit whichever I have drawn, it is very nearer to the Earth, very nearer to the Sun. Mercury, Venus. Third position is the Earth, Mars, which is also called as a red planet, isn't it? If you might know about. Then comes Jupiter. It is the large planet. It is also known as the largest planet. Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. So each planet has its own identity. Okay, so on which planet we exist? We exist on Earth. It is on the third position. It is on the third orbit and it is in the third position from the sun. Okay, so it is not hotter as we are far away from the sun. Then coming to asteroids. What are asteroids? Asteroids are small rocky things that orbit the sun. Okay, they are the small rocky things. The sun and our Earth are tiny parts of a galaxy. They are not complete part. They are the tiny part, a little part of galaxy. Okay. What do you mean by galaxy? Galaxies is many galaxies. You find many number of galaxies in the universe, in the solar system. But the galaxy which the sun and our Earth consists is known as the Milky Way galaxy. It is named as Milky Way galaxy. Okay, children. So when you look at the sky during the night, a group of stars, you find like some shapes are formed, isn't it? So those are called as constellations. Okay, the famous constellation names are Orion and Big Dipper. So you find group of stars, isn't it? Some stars in the form of, say, some they are in slanting or the vertical ones, 3 in 3 in 4, some are in some different shapes. So those group of stars which form patterns in the sky, those patterns seems to look like shapes, isn't it, of different objects. Sometimes you find like an animal over there. It depends. So those are called as constellations. Normally you sometimes you find this star, it is called as a pole star or it's also called as the North Star. The pole star is the brightest star in the sky. It is special because it shines a lot. Okay, remember them. Normally travelers, you take the help of this star for traveling in the north direction. Especially they find that they'll come to know with this, they are moving in the north direction. It helps them to find the north direction. To whom it helps? The travelers. Who are travelers? Who travel from one place to another place. This is the sun. Third place. Or eight. Okay, so what do you mean by the earth rotates or spins or revolves? The earth revolves as well as or spins around itself. When you turn around and round, when you turn round and round, the rotation or the spin or the spinning of earth. So when the planets, they don't just stand in their places, they keep on moving. Okay, they rotate, or you can also call as spinning. As you people move around and round, the planets also will spin in their own orbit as well as around the sun. They revolve. That is called revolution. Okay, the rotation and the revolution keeps on going around the sun. So that is the reason we have, when the earth faces the part of earth, when it faces to the sun, the day is formed. And the part of sun which is away from the earth, which is the other part which is not facing the sun, that part of earth faces night. Okay children, again, when the earth moves round and round, rotates as well as revolves around the orbit, this is the orbit. And sun itself has a lot of light of itself. So it is having its own light. So it is the only member of the solar system family. You can call it as their family. So it is the only member of the solar system which is having its own light. So till now what we have seen, the sun, 8 planets, consists of the solar system with the comets, asteroids, constellations, galaxies. We all came through all those things, isn't it? The what did I say? These things which were on which what they revolve, the planets revolve in an orbit. Okay, it is in the shape of an egg, the oval shape. I'm sorry, I have drawn I have drew in this way. Okay, then and here we didn't come across the satellite. So moon is called the satellite, only natural satellite of Earth. The Earth is having the natural, in the sense it is not then artificial. It is not what do you mean by artificial and natural? Natural is it existed from the nature itself. Artificial is the man-made. Many satellites are man-made. Those are the artificial satellites which help in knowing the weather, the conditions and all. Okay, so this is the end of the topic.